Hello to all my day drinkers out there. I'm Martini Pictures, and welcome back to Doki Doki Literature Club. So we're kind of like stuck in this scenario where nothing's going right, and all hell is breaking loose. There has to be a way to save this, right? We went with Yuri yesterday, so let's go with Natsuki a little bit more today. Whoa, Joy. Why was that hers? That's right. Joy would have been Sayori's. That might have been why I had... No. Well, actually, maybe. Like, maybe I had chosen a whole bunch of Sayoris that ended up being fake Natsukis. I don't know. I don't even remember, like, how many I've chosen, but I think... I think it's a little bit more on Natsuki's side this time. Oh! Jeez. This game knows exactly when to put in shit. Another one just came in. What time is it? 10:09, so this was just added now. I. I hate this. I can't do anything. Nothing. No matter how many times you play, it's all the same. It would be really, really easy to kill myself right now. But that would mean I don't get to talk to you anymore. All I want is for you to hate them. Why is that so hard? Huh. Okay. Back over there you go. Another day passes and it's time for the club meeting already. I've gotten a little more comfortable here over the past couple days. Entering the club room, the usual scene greets me.
Welcome back, Jade.
Hi, Yuri. I'm not sure if it's me or if it's Yuri's expression, but the weight of yesterday's quarrel still hangs in the air a little. Yuri glances over her shoulder looking around the room. Natsuki is reading manga at a desk, and surprisingly, Monika isn't here yet. Suddenly, Yuri takes my arm and pulls me into the corner of the room.
About yesterday, I really need to apologize. Nothing like that has ever happened before. And something just came over me, I guess. I wasn't acting mentally sound. Please don't think we're usually like this. Not just me, but Natsuki as well.
Yuri.
I'm happy that you were considerate and apologized. You don't have to worry too much. Even though I've only been here a couple days, I could tell something was off yesterday. Maybe we were just a little extra sensitive because it was our first time sharing poems.
Did I hear an extra note in that? Weird. I'm just continuously looking over there, like, for something to pop up.
whatever it was, it didn't make me think any less of you. I'd already decided that there's no way you can be a bad person. And now that you're apologizing, I know you really didn't mean it.
Jade, don't say those kinds of things so frankly. Make me a little too happy. I'm really glad that you're such an understanding person. And I'm really glad that you joined this club. Everything is a little bit brighter with you around, and... Sorry, what am I saying right now? I just...
Hey! Have you guys seen Monica?
No, I haven't. I was also kind of wondering where she was. I was also kind of wondering where she was.
Man! Yuri, I'm guessing you haven't either.
Yuri clearly is taken aback by how calmly Natsuki is addressing her.
No, I haven't.
Jeez, this isn't like her at all! I know it's stupid, but I can't help but worry a little bit. What? Why are you looking at me like that?
Natsuki, about yesterday? I just wanted to apologize. I promise I didn't mean any of those things I said. And I'll do my best to stay under control from now on. So...
Yuri! What the heck are you talking about? Did you do something yesterday? Jeez!
Alright.
Whatever's on your mind, I'm sure it was nothing. I don't even remember anything bad happening. You're the kind of person who worries a little too much about little things, aren't you?
But...
I'll accept your apology anyway, if it helps you feel any better about it. Besides, it's kinda nice to hear, since I was always afraid you secretly hated me or something like that.
Where the hell did that come from? That is the best feminine laugh, like overly effeminate laugh I've ever had, I think.
No, not at all. I don't hate you.
Well, you're kind of weird, but I don't hate you either.
Natsuki turns to me.
You're still on trial, though. Hey!
Suddenly, the door swings open.
Sorry, I'm super sorry.
There you are.
I didn't mean to be late. I hope you guys weren't worried or anything.
Nah. Well, Natsuki was.
I was not!
Weird.
What took you so long, anyway?
Well, my last period today was study hall. To be honest, I kind of just lost track of time.
That makes most sense, though. You would have heard the bell ring at least.
I must not have heard it since I was practicing piano.
Piano?
Piano? I was unaware you played music as well, Monica. Don't give me more credit than I deserve. I guess I've been practicing for a while, but I'm still not really good yet. Still? That must require a lot of dedication. So I'm still impressed. Well, thanks, Yuri.
You should play something for us sometime.
Monica looks at me. Well, at least working on
writing a song, but it's not... Well, I am working on writing a song, but it's not quite done yet. Maybe once I get a little bit better, I will.
That sounds cool. I look forward to it.
Is that so? In that case... I won't let you down, Jade.
Monica smiles sweetly. I didn't mean any pressure or anything like that.
Don't worry. I was hoping I could share it with you anyway.
I guess that's why I've been practicing so much recently. I see. I'm not sure if Monica is referring to the whole club or just me. In that case, best of luck. Thanks. So I didn't miss anything, did I? Not really. I choose not to bring up anything about the three of us talked about. Besides, Natsuki has already run off into the closet. Jade? Since your compliments put me in a good mood, I was wondering if you'd like to spend some time together today? I mean, in the club. Yeah, definitely. I planned on it anyway. Okay! Can we start now? Let's find a place to sit. I'm being a little forceful, aren't I? I'm sorry. Wait a minute. I thought I had more in Natsuki's route. What the hell? My heart just won't stop pounding for some reason. Don't worry about it. If anything, it's nice to see you have so much energy. Yeah. But I need to try to calm down. I won't be able to focus on reading like this. Take your time. Yuri takes a deep breath and pulls a copy of the book out of her bag. That was a weird transition. It's normally not like this. Actually, I have a request. Do you mind if I make some tea first? Not at all. Thanks very much. If there's one thing that can make my reading time here any better, it's a nice cup of tea. Not to mention for yourself as well. Yuri stands up and makes her way to the closet. I follow and watch as she retrieves a small water pitcher from the shelf, the kind with a filter in it inside. Can you hold this for a second? Sure. Yuri hands me the water pitcher and also fetches an electric kettle. I'm going to plug this into the teacher's desk, so I'll go get some water. She walks past me and sets the kettle down on the teacher's desk. I simply watch her movements. To my surprise, the way she moves really contrasts her speaking mannerisms, especially because of her long legs, Yuri appears elegant and methodical. Okay, may I have the water pitcher? Thanks, I'll be right back. I might as well walk with you. That's okay. You stay here. It won't take long. Pitcher in hand, Yuri hurries out of the classroom. Ah, did Yuri leave you again? No, it's not like that this time. She's just filling up the water pitcher to make tea. Oh, okay. Sorry for misunderstanding. All I can imagine in, like, this part, just, like, silence. Like, I can just imagine, like, the character just, like, sitting down and just, like, drumming his desk, but, like, really nonchalantly and not giving a care in the world. Like, Monica, who he, like, adores and treats, like, as a god, is just, like, standing, like, right in front of him, and he's just, like... That's all I can imagine. 10 minutes passed. 10 minutes? Yuri said it wouldn't take long. Something holding her up? I'm bored just waiting here, so I decide to go look for her. What the hell? It's kind of a cool effect. They muffled the song. Let's see. Most logical place for Yuri to be would be the nearest water fountain. I start heading down the hallway. What's that noise? It's coming from around the corner. Sounds like breathing. Sharp inhale. Oh, inhale. Like someone sucking air through their teeth. Oh. Like that. Should have been more like a hiss, I think. Are they in pain? I reach the corner and I peer around it. Yuri? I was right. Even though that self-harm is not, like, good or okay, it is a reality, and just... I guess I just need to be the one to help her.
Oh, what the fuck?
It's going backwards. Okay. I'm back. Thanks for waiting patiently. Jade, do you like oolong tea? Wait, isn't there like a jade tea as well? Ah, yeah. Anything is fine. Very well. Yuri sets the temperature on the kettle to 200 degrees. Now it's time to get the teapot. You really do this properly, don't you? Of course. I shouldn't do any less than when I'm making tea for others. Even if I'm not an expert on tea or anything? In that case, you'll only be even more impressed. Perhaps I will. Oh shit. Right-clicked. Yuri fetches the teapot and begins measuring the tea leaves. To my surprise, she even starts humming a little to herself. You must be in a good mood now. Is that so? I was letting it show. And you noticed. I was doing a bit of thinking. And I decided that I would try expressing myself a little bit more. I'm just taking a look real quick over on my left. Oh well. It turns out it's not very hard for me to do. And it's you who's around anyway? That's great, Yuri. Just don't push yourself too much. You're always worrying about me, Jade. It's very endearing. That's... Yuri wasn't kidding. I don't even know if I can keep up with this. I watch Yuri pour a cup of tea for each of us. Jade, I have another request. Do you mind if we sit on the floor today? Alright. Why is that? It's a little easier on my back. I can read with my back against the wall rather than bending over at my desk. Sorry, I didn't realize. No worries. I just have back pain fairly regularly, so I do my best to manage it. Is that so? I wonder why that is. It's mostly because of my... I know the reason. Your posture, right? Always hunched over like that while reading? Yes! I have terrible reading posture. So, that's why we should sit on the floor. Fair enough. I'll go ahead and get the book. I retrieved the book from my bag. I have some chocolate as well. Where the hell did that come from? It's a bag of small chocolate candies. I take it, since it'll go well with the tea. Yuri and I sit against the wall, teacups at our sides. I guess my mouse was like moving. Wait a minute. The hell? My mouse wasn't detecting anything. But it was moving on its own. Weird. As if in sync, we assumed the same reading position as last time, each holding one half of the book. Except this time, our bodies are even closer together, to each other. I can't see too well. Yuri slides closer until our shoulders are touching. How am I supposed to focus on reading like this? Yuri was always kind of cute, but when she's being less apprehensive, it's almost more than I can handle. Your teacup. Your teacup? Yuri hands me my teacup. Holding it with my hand, that's not holding the book, I end up in a position that makes it even harder to focus. Because now, I need to worry about making sure I don't actually touch her chest. Of course. Meanwhile, Yuri still hasn't noticed a single thing. She wears her intense reading expression, and I can only presume the world around her has faded away. I use all my willpower to focus on reading. After a few minutes, I finally manage to relax a little. I put the teacup between my legs and fumble with the chocolate wrapper. Sorry. I briefly let go of the book to finish opening the wrapper.
You can have as much as... Oh,
you can have as much as you want.
That's okay. I won't take any.
Are you sure?
Well, if I touch it, then it might get smudges on the pages.
You're right. I didn't even think about that. My bad.
No need to apologize. I'll hold the book, okay?
Are you sure?
Of course.
I like that little effect that they have with the dust floating. It's cool. Yuri opens the book with both hands. She holds it so that I don't have to have any harder of a time reading from it. But as a result, her left arm is practically resting on top of my leg. Well, in that case, Yuri is already totally focused on reading again. I take a chocolate candy and pop it into my mouth. Then I take another chocolate, and I hold it up to Yuri. She doesn't even look away from the book. She simply parts her lips as if the situation was completely natural. So it's just like, ah. That means I can't stop here. I apprehensively place the chocolate in her mouth. Just like that, Yuri closes her lips around it. Huh? Yuri's expression suddenly breaks.
Did I just...
Yuri looks at me like she needs to confirm what just happened.
Jade...
Sorry. I guess I shouldn't have done that. All time is froze. Yuri starts to breathe heavily.
I can't... Jade...
Suddenly, Yuri forcefully grabs my arm and jerks me to my feet. My teacup gets knocked over.
Jade?
Oh, hello.
My heart won't stop pounding, Jade. I can't calm down. I can't focus on anything anymore. Can you feel it, Jade?
Yuri suddenly presses my hand against her chest. I do not like that at all.
Why is this happening to me?
There goes my mouse again. What the hell?
I feel like I'm losing my mind. I can't make it stop. It even makes me not want to read. I just want to look at you.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, God, that's even worse. Please make it end. Oh, thank God.
It's time to share poems.
I don't want to go back to Yuri just yet. I want to go to the safest person right now, and that's Natsuki.
Well, it's not really any worse than your last one. I can't really say it's any better either.
Huh?
Huh? Phew, what?
Well, anything that isn't a train wreck, I'll take as a win. Excuse me. And I get the feeling you're probably the most critical.
Hey!
Why did that voice not come out?
Hey!
Oh God. Time for a sip. Time for a fix.
Hey! What makes you...
Wait. Maybe that was a compliment.
Glad to see someone recognizes my experience. Well then, keep practicing and maybe you'll be good as me someday.
That's, something tells me not to completely miss the point.
Just make sure you find a little bit of influence from everyone. I think you're at least being influenced by Yuri a little bit, aren't you? I mean, I know you've been, like, spending more time with her or whatever. But you know, Monica and I are just as good as her. Poems, I mean. So you should really try to learn something or you'll never get better. Here's the one I wrote. I'll make sure you learn something from it.
This is the Amy Likes Spiders one, so... This hasn't changed.
Not bad, right?
I'm just glad that nothing has changed about her, except having her memory wiped, basically. Her character design seems to be the same, but... nothing else. It's quite a bit longer than yesterday's.
Yesterday's was way too short. I was just warming up. I hope you didn't think that was the best I could do.
No, of course not.
Anyway, the message is pretty straightforward in this poem. I doubt I have to explain it. Like anyone would agree that the subject of this poem is an ignorant jerk. Everyone has some kind of weird hobby or a guilty pleasure. Something that you're afraid of if people find out. They'd make fun of you or think less of you. But that just makes people stupid. Who cares what someone likes, as long as they're not hurting anyone, and it makes them happy. I think people really need to learn to respect others for liking weird things. Such as two of the girls in this very club, whom I respectfully won't name. Kind of ironic that even in my one place of comfort, I can't even have people respect me. Jeez, now you're making me complain too much.
What did I do? For what it's worth, I respect you.
Well, I guess thanks. But it's kind of obvious that you respect Yuri more, so... Whatever, we're done sharing, so you can leave now.
I kind of want to avoid Yuri a little bit longer. Jade, I think you saw something earlier you weren't supposed to see. I didn't want to have to tell you this, but I don't think I have a choice. It's getting kind of dangerous for you to spend so much time with Yuri. I don't know why, but she seems pretty easily excitable when she's around you. Which shouldn't be a problem in itself. But when Yuri gets too excited, she finds a place to hide and starts cutting herself with a pocket knife. Wait a minute, how would she know that? Everything was reset a while ago. I mean, what am I saying? She's the one that's basically, like, controlling, like, everything around her in a certain sense. But even herself, I don't think is right. Like, there's some, like, if I were to draw her, like, well, the way that I would draw her would be this way, and then, like, a black haze around her. Like, there's something taking her over. Like, it's not just her that has the ability. It's something outside that is making her do this, but is also becoming, like, a huge mess for everyone else. Isn't that kind of messed up? She even brings a different one to school every day. Like, she has a collection or something. I mean, it's definitely not because she's depressed or anything like that. I think she just gets some kind of high from it. It might even be, like, a sexual thing. But the point is, you've kind of been enabling her. I'm not saying it's your fault, though. But I guess that's why I had to explain it to all of you. Explain it all to you. So I think if you keep your distance, that would probably be the best for her. While you're at it, don't be shy to spend a little more time with me. with me. To put it lightly, I at least have it I have it together in my head. And I know how to treat my club members. Clearly you don't if you're saying this shit. But anyway, you want to read my poem now? I like the way this one turned out, so I hope you do too. Save me. The colors, they won't bright. Oh, this one's different. Save me. The colors, they won't bright, beautiful colors, flashing, expanding, piercing, red, green, blue, an endless cacophony of meaningless noise. The noise, it won't stop. Violent, grating, waveforms, squeaking, screeching, piercing, sine, cosine, tangent. Like a chalkboard on a turntable. Like playing a knife on a breathing ribcage. Okay. An endless something of meaningless. Delete. That's different. Okay, so we're just gonna click off of that right quick. Okay. Sorry, I know it's kind of abstract. I'm just trying to... Well, never mind. There's no point in explaining. I don't know how my mouse ended up all the way up there. Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Sometimes you'll find yourself facing a difficult decision. When that happens, don't forget to save your game, which I'm gonna do right now, actually. Here. You never know when, who am I talking to? Can you hear me? See, it is affecting her. There is something that's on the outside. It's not her. Tell me you can hear me. Anything. Please help me. Okay. That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening. Alright, Yuri. I've been waiting for this. Let's see what you've written for today. Yuri smiles and takes a deep breath. I like just holding it. I mean, the poem turned out good. It's, well, there are some things you could work on, but that doesn't really matter. It feels like anything written by you is a treasure. It came out a little awkward.
You know what? I want to see if she'll treasure something that's entirely Natsuki. Next time I'm just going to go all cute, all everything pink, and see if she still enjoys it. That might be a hard reset for her. That might just reset her, fix herself, and make her, like, get back to her senses.
That came out a little awkward. Let's move on. Here's the poem I wrote. You don't have to like it or anything.
Wheel. This is a new one, right? A rotating wheel, turning on an axle, grinding, bolt head, linear gearbox, falling sky, seven holy stakes, a dock ship, a portal to another world, a thin rope tied to a thick rope, a torn harness, parabolic gearbox, expanding universe, time controlled by slipping... What the hell is this? What are these stains? Have those always been there? I guess I never noticed. Where was I?
Time controlled by slipping cogwheels, existence of God, swimming with open water in all directions, drowning, A prayer written in blood. A prayer written in time-devouring snakes with human eyes.
Okay, that's a little stretch.
A thread connecting all living human eyes. A kaleidoscope of holy stakes. Exponential gearbox. A sky of exploding stars. God disproving the existence of God. A wheel rotating in 6 dimensions. 40 gears and a ticking clock. A clock that ticks 1 second for every rotation of the planet. A clock that ticks 40 times every time it ticks every second. Every second time. A bolt head of holy stakes tied to an existence of a dock ship to another world. A kaleidoscope of blood written in clocks. A time-devouring prayer connecting to a sky of 40 gears and an open eyes in all directions. Breathing gearbox, breathing bolt head, breathing ship, breathing portal, breathing snakes, breathing God, breathing blood, breathing holy stakes, breathing human eyes, breathing time, breathing prayer, breathing sky, breathing wheel. Okay. It doesn't really matter what it's about. My mind has been a little hyperactive lately, so I had to take it out on your pen. A pen fell out of your pocket yesterday, so I took it home for safekeeping, and I just really like the way that it writes. So I wrote this poem with it. And now you're touching it. I still want to avoid you. I'm okay. What did I just... Can we just pretend this conversation never happened? You can keep the poem, though. You've unlocked a special poem. Would you like to read it? Nothing on the other side, but sure. Things I like about Papa. I like when Papa comes home early. I like when Papa cooks me dinner. I like when Papa gives me allowance. I like Papa. I like when Papa spends time with me. I like when Papa asks me about my friends. Okay, it's not every fifth line that the lines are there. What are those lines about? I like when Papa asks me about anything. I like when Papa gives me lunch money. I like when Papa comes home before sundown. I like when Papa cooks. I like when when Papa gives me privacy. I like when Papa doesn't tell me how to dress. I like when Papa doesn't comment on my friends. I like when Papa doesn't comment on my hobbies. I like when Papa doesn't... I like when Papa comes home without waking me up. I like when Papa uses his inside voice. I like when Papa leaves my stuff alone. I like when Papa accidentally drops coins in the couch. I like when Papa is too tired to notice me. I like when Papa is too tired for anything. I like when Papa is too tired for anything. Huh. Whoa, what the hell? Okay, everyone. No, no, no! We're all done reading each other's poems, right? We have something we need to go over today, so if everyone could come sit at the front of the room. Is this about
Is this about the festival?
Well, sort of. If I distract myself with the voices.
Do we really have to do something for the festival? It's not like we put together anything good in just a few days. We'll just end up embarrassing ourselves instead of getting any new members.
Whoa, why are you fading? Do I click? Whoa!
I don't really do with last-minute preparations. Don't worry so much. We're going to keep it simple, okay? Look, I know everyone's been a little more lively ever since Jay joined, and we've started with some club activities. But this isn't the first time for us to be complacent. This isn't the time for us to be complacent. We still only have 4 members. And the festival is our only real chance to find more, you know?
What's so great about getting new members anyway? We already have enough to be considered an official club. More members will just mean everything gets noisier and more difficult to manage.
Natsuki, I don't think you're looking at it the right way at all. Don't you want to share your passion with as many people as you can? To inspire them to find the same feelings that brought you in here in the first place? The Literature Club should be a place where people can express themselves like they can't do anywhere else. It should be a place so intimate that you never want to leave. I know you feel that way too. I know we all do. So that's why we should work together. That's why we should work hard and put something together for the festival. Even if it's something small. Right, Jade?
Oh, come on! You can't take advantage of Jade just to agree with you just because he doesn't know how to say no to anything. Look, Monica! Do you really think any of us here joined the club with any other people in mind? Yuri never talked until Jade joined. As for me, I just like it better here than I do at home. And Jade isn't even passionate about literature in the first place. And that's everyone. Sorry, but you're really the only real... You're the only one who's interested in finding new members. The rest of us are just fine like this. I know you're president and all, but you should really consider your opinions for once.
Monica is clearly taken aback by Natsuki's words. That's not true at all. I'm sure Yuri and Jade want to get more members too, right? I don't know about Yuri, but I'm kind of indifferent. If it showed as much enthusiasm as Monica wanted, then I probably would be lying. Still, if it's up to me to rescue this situation, no. Natsuki's right, isn't she? This club, it's nothing more than a place for a few people to hang out. Why did I think that everyone here saw it the same way as I did? But that doesn't mean that we're against getting new members or anything. Jade, why did you even join this club? What were you hoping to get out of it?
Well, it's not really something I can be honest about, is it?
In fact, if I remember, you weren't even given a choice to join.
Monica sits down and stares at her desk.
What's the point of all of this, anyway? What if starting this club was a mistake? Now you've done it, Natsuki.
What? Me? I just spoke my mind. Is it a crime to be honest?
It's not about being honest. It's about word choice. Besides, you have no right to speak for everyone else in the club like that.
You don't understand at all! I just want a place that feels nice to hang out with a few friends. Is there a problem with the club being that for me? There aren't many other places like that for me. And now Monica wants to take it away from me.
She's not taking anything away.
No, Jade. It's not the same. It won't be the same with the direction she wants to take it. If I wanted that, then I could have just joined any other stupid club. But this one... I mean... At least for a little bit of time... Things were nice.
Natsuki starts packing up her things.
I'm going home. I feel like I don't belong here right now.
Natsuki.
Natsuki ignores Yuri and walks right out of the classroom.
This is bad. I don't know what to do.
Well, do you have an opinion on the festival?
I don't know. I'm kind of indifferent, I guess.
Oh, shit!
Who cares about that obnoxious brat?
Oh, it's right back. Good.
I mean, I like how nice and quiet the club is right now. And I'm just happy with you here. But still, I'm the vice president. It's not right for me to ignore my responsibilities like that.
Nobody would care if she killed herself.
Oh, what the fuck?
I should do my best to consider everyone's perspective and make the decision that's right for the club. What about you, Jade? What do you want to get out of this club?
Yuri repeats the same question as Monica. I decide giving an indirect answer is better than nothing. I think the most important thing is for everyone to get along. And for the club to provide... And for the club to provide something that you can't get anywhere else. I don't think it's about how many members, but rather the quality of each member. That's what will end up making the Literature Club a special place.
I see. I really agree with you. Each member can...
I thought I saw something up here. The blood is carrying over. What the fuck?
Each member contributes their own qualities in a special way. With each change in members, the identity of the club as a whole will change too. I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing. Stepping out of your comfort zone once in a while. So if you would like to help Monica with the festival, then I'm on your side as well.
Alright. Well, maybe we can all talk to Natsuki tomorrow. Yuri nods.
Hey, Yuri?
Huh?
I know things were a little awkward yesterday. But I feel like you deserve to know that I still think you're a wonderful vice president. And also, a wonderful friend. Monica. I want to do everything I can to make this the best club ever. Okay? Me too.
Yeah!
Let's all go home for today. We'll talk about the festival tomorrow. Okay. I look forward to it. Shall we go, Jade? Please don't take this the wrong way, but I'm going to chat a little bit with Jade before we leave. Just to see what he thinks of his time here and all that. It's important to me, as president.
Yuri looks a little troubled, but she doesn't protest.
Okay. I trust your judgment, Monica. In that case, I'll see the two of you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow!
Monica waves as Yuri exits the classroom.
Things have been a bit hectic lately. Things have been a bit hectic lately, haven't they?
I just remembered her voice. Like, I completely lost it. I realized that, like, midway through, like, someone's passage, I was like... Whoa, the background's fading out.
Jade, I just wanted to make sure you're enjoying your time at this club. I really hate to see you unhappy. I feel kind of like I'm responsible for that as president.
Everything quit.
And I really do care about you, you know? I don't like seeing the other girls give you a hard time. With how mean Natsuki is and everything. And Yuri being a little bit... You know. Sometimes it feels like you and I are the only real people here. You know what I mean? But it's weird. Because in all the time that you've been here, we've hardly gotten to spend any time together. I guess it's technically only been a couple days. Sorry, I didn't mean to say something weird. There's just some things I've been hoping to talk about with you. Things I know only you can understand. So that's why... Wait, not yet. No.
Huh. See, she doesn't have control of the situation. There's something else that's there doing it. It's not her. Oh. I guess I'll save. It just keeps getting more and more odd. Well, I guess all I can really say is if you liked any part of this video, don't forget to leave a like down below. Leave any comments or any videos you want to see in the future, and don't forget to subscribe as well as ring the bell to let you know when I post another video. Without you guys, my life would be in pieces. Just get